We are going to talk about next organic chemistry. In organic chemistry, we have first chapter, basic principles. What is the first chapter? Basic principles of organic chemistry. Then we have hydrocarbons. In which we are going to talk about alkanes, alkenes, alkynes, aromatic compounds. Okay. Then in 12th standard, these two are 11th class chapters. Then in 12th standard, we'll talk about halogen compounds. And alcohols, phenols, and ethers. This is one more chapter. Then we have aldehydes, ketones, and carboxylic acids. Then we have nitrogen containing compounds. And let's also study biomolecules. Polymers, chemistry in everyday life, and also let's include environmental. Otherwise, that's a separate topic, but let's say we'll study also environmental pollution or chemistry, you can say. Okay, so these are all the topics we are going to cover in organic chemistry. Again, if we study first chapter, basic principles, then it will be huge advantage to understand hydrocarbons. And then halogen compounds, alcohol, phenol, ether, so on and so forth. How it is useful, you see here. Let's say in first chapter, basic principles, I am talking about nomenclature. If I am talking about nomenclature, let's say this is the compound. CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. This is one compound. CH3, CH2, OH. This is another compound. CH3, C double bond O, CH3. This is another compound. CH3, C double bond OH. This is another compound. Now we need to name them based on IUPAC system. Based on IUPAC system, we are trying to name them. There are certain rules. Like if you see the first compound, 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. According to IUPAC system, 4 carbon means it is butte. Butte means 4 carbons. Then if you see the bonding, in this case, all of them are single bonds. If you want to expand the structure, do it like this. CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. All of them are single bonds. Whenever single bonds are there, that means it is alkane. So the later part of alkane, ANE, must be adding here as a suffix. So bute plus A, it is butane. So this comes under which one? Alkanes. Similarly, see the second one. How many carbons are there? 1, 2. 2 carbons means, according to IUPAC system, it. It means 2 carbons. What are the bonds here? Again, single bonds only. So it should be ethane. But I am not writing ethane completely. Why? Because along with this carbons and hydrogen, OH group is present. OH group means what? Hydroxy group. Whenever OH group is present, functional group OH, then the compound will be called as alcohol. So in this case, OH is present to first carbon. So this will be called as what? Ethanol. That means E of alkane is removed and OL of alcohol is added to ethane. So this becomes what? Ethanol. See, I'll talk about all these things in detail later. Why I am talking write this particular concept now? Because to make you understand that these concepts which you are going to study in basic principles are going to be repeated. We are going to repeat them. See here, 1, 2, 3 carbons. 3 carbon means prop. Okay. You have a double bond O. That is ketonic group. So this will be called as propanone. ONE should be added. Just like OL is added, here ONE I am adding to propane. E removed, ONE added. Similarly here, 1, 2 carbons. So again it is it. This is aldehyde group. CHO is aldehyde. So it is ethanol. Difference is OL, it is alcohol. AL, it is aldehyde. Why I am talking all these things? Because here hydrocarbons, alkanes, alkenes, alkynes or halogen compounds or alcohols, aldehyde, ketone, whatever. In all these chapters, whatever structures, compounds will be there, we will try to name them based on IUPAC system. We have already studied IUPAC system in basic principles. So obviously that is going to help us to understand nomenclature in again all these chapters. Not only nomenclature, we will also study in basic principles about isomerism. We will talk about reagents. We will talk about type of reactions, substitution, addition, all these things again. We will study in all these chapters. That means this is the backbone for organic chemistry. Once we study this chapter thoroughly, then we will apply all those concepts for remaining chapters like hydrocarbons, halogen compounds, alcohol phenol ethers, aldehyde, ketone, carboxylic acids and nitrogen containing compounds. Here in biomolecules, we will talk about carbohydrates. Familiar to everybody. Along with carbohydrates, we will study proteins, we will study vitamins, we will study hormones, and we will also study nucleic acids. In your school, you have studied about vitamins and hormones. What are vitamins? You know, nutrients, hormones, chemical messengers, nucleic acids, DNA, RNA, carbohydrates, sugars like glucose, fructose, sucrose, lactose, maltose. These all things we'll study under biomolecules chapter. Their structure also, their preparation also, all those things we'll study under biomolecules. Then in polymers, we'll talk about polythene, polymer, mer, single part, poly, many, combination of many parts is nothing but polymer. So in polymers, we'll talk about several examples related to polymers. Like Tylon, you can say Teflon, Nylon, Terylene, then you can say Bakelite, all these examples, don't get worried. We will talk all those things very simple way. You don't have to worry about those things. It's a very simple chapter but very, very important. You are going to get one question definitely from polymers. chemistry in everyday life, drug chemistry. See, if we get stomachache or any particular pain, we take a medicine. That medicine you call it as aspirin. Aspirin. What is aspirin? You call it as analgesic agent. What do you mean by analgesic? Pain reliever. So like that in chemistry in everyday life, we will talk about some drugs, their structure and mode of activity. What is the use of that particular medicine? That is what we are going to study in chemistry in everyday life. Chemistry, this is actually a separate topic. We can consider this as a general chemistry part, but I have written it here, environmental chemistry. That is environmental pollution, in fact, you can say. Soil pollution, air pollution, water pollution, sound pollution. Literally all these things we'll study here. What are the reasons for pollution? How to prevent pollution? What are the effects of pollution? All those things we'll study here. Along with that, we'll also talk about global warming, greenhouse effect, ozone depletion, ozone layer depletion, acid rain, all these terms which are general topics, we will cover under environmental chemistry. So this is all about organic chemistry. You have a phobia towards organic chemistry. Don't worry. First chapter, if we concentrate thoroughly, if we fix those concepts in our brain and practice them regularly, then all these chapters of organic chemistry will be very, very easy for you. Okay, hope you have understood what is that we are actually going to study in organic chemistry.